last video on this. We are talking about making sure that you have very clear boundaries with your ex that you have children with if you ever plan on dating or remarrying. What's good, John Lonnie Appleton? I am a healthy family advocate. If that is your type of content, please consider following, commenting, reposting, and sharing links with your community so that we can commune together. Okay, this is the last video. My husband allowed himself to be manipulated by his ex because he had children with them and he had the guilt of not having his children with him anymore. I don't know, I think I messed up a word there, but welcome to the Lonnie Show, that's what I do. Because he's carrying this guilt, he is allowing himself to be manipulated by his ex. And then when I showed up, I was like, well, this has to stop, sir. First of all, you need to start paying your child support instead of giving her money directly. The amount of money that he was giving her directly was substantially more than the court-ordered child support. So when my husband just started paying the court-ordered child support, now the mother who was living on the money that he was giving him now has to figure out, how the heck am I gonna cover these bills since I can't call him and get money anymore because that Chelani is in the way now. My husband left me in a very unfortunate situation because he never addressed it before I showed up. And he never addressed it after I showed up. So Lonnie showed up and became the boundary maker. And when I put boundaries in place, the kids didn't like it because dad was good time, fun time, weekend dad. I come over dad and I spend up all his money and I eat up all his food and I trash his house and then I go home. Lonnie showed up and was like, oh, we're never gonna get out of this one bedroom if we're going and spending $300-$500 every weekend at the movies and the mall. And pick your trash up off of the floor and actually put it in the trash can. So yeah, it was a big drama. I was very expressive. And Dre couldn't understand where I was coming from. Even to this day, he doesn't understand where I was coming from. He doesn't see that his children would deliberately do things to attack me. And so I stood in the position where I was just like, hold up. You can't play fair. I can't do anything to you, but I can't prevent you from coming over here. So we had plenty of family meetings where we were like, look, if you can't be respectful, you can't come over. If you can't be respectful, you can't come over. My stepchildren used to come in my house and not speak to me, walk right on past me. And that's easy work right there. It got real nasty. And it's all because the man did not put any boundaries up front because he felt guilt because he was no longer in his children's lives. So he allowed his ex to unofficially date him and get dating boyfriend privileges. But when a woman showed up and she's like, you're not dating me and her at the same time, he now has to make boundaries. But why did he make those boundaries? The new woman. So you are setting your woman up to be a problem if you do not set boundaries up in the beginning. So please, I know you feel guilt. Boundaries. And I know with the mention of child support, people are like, he wasn't paying his child support. What's good, John Lonnie Appleton? I am a healthy family advocate. If that is your type of content, please consider following, commenting, sharing, and reposting videos with your community so that we can commune together. All right. Yes, so we are talking about setting boundaries with the woman you have children with if you ever plan on dating or remarrying. Without setting those boundaries, when you do begin dating, that new woman will become the enemy of your children. And definitely if the ex doesn't have her together, she's going to use them children like, look, the reason why we can't get this done anymore by your dad is because of her. The reason why we can't get money from your dad anymore is because of her. The reason why we can't is because your dad and her. All of that happened with me because my husband allowed himself to be dated by his ex until he got into a serious relationship. And I'm sure every woman before me didn't mind or didn't matter because they weren't his wife. And you guys are doing this to these women because you're just like, yeah, I'm just dating because I want to have sex and I want somebody to cook me breakfast. But when you find a wife, and when this woman comes in and she starts changing stuff, no woman before changed anything. No other woman got dad to change, but this new woman did. It's because this new woman is the woman. All those other chicks were classrooms. We don't make no changes for classrooms. We just soak up them lessons and we let them motherfuckers go. But the one that shows up and you know that's your husband or you know that's your wife, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. So you know that's your wife, ladies. You don't find him, he finds you. Per me, but what do I know? Let me mind my business. But when he finds you, that means he's gonna love you. He's gonna do whatever it takes to keep you because he values you. If you find him, you're gonna do whatever it takes to keep him. And if you're doing whatever it takes to keep him, he is definitely not doing whatever it takes to keep you. Just pay attention to your relationships and report in the comments and let me know. So men, you want to make sure that you are setting boundaries before you find the one. So when the one shows up, there's no conflict between your children. There may be with your ex because she's petty, but that ain't got nothing to do with nothing. Your children know, and you speak to them. When you come in this house, you respect her. She's going to treat you with respect. You're going to respect her, and we're going to kumbaya on this. When you leave and go back to your mammy's house, y'all do all the dysfunction. But over here, we're going to be in love and light. Men, that is the conversation you need to have to support your wife. If you're not having that conversation, like I said, we lost years. Derek died in drama because nobody spoke up and said, hey, I know your mom's out here manipulating you. We ain't got no problems over here. All of our problems came from me trying to stand my ground because I'm not going to be punked. Even if it's a child being manipulated by their mother. And then with the child support, my husband went from giving her money directly to actually paying money through the clearinghouse, and we were able to pay that bill off. They was taking my taxes every year. Like, man, y'all make sure y'all's paying y'all's child support, because what business you don't handle today, your future wife will have to deal with tomorrow. And through the years, I would overpay and triple pay, but you cannot get out of child support debt. So do not allow it to happen. Unless you do a lump sum payment, you can't get out. In the end, divine timing. When the last child was turning 18, we happened to have the $14,000 on hand to write the final check, and we paid it off and haven't heard from the mom since. When the mom disappeared, suddenly we all have renewed relationships with the children. Please stop using these children as tools of manipulation.
Yeah, international, underground, thunder bounce when I stop the ground. Like a million elephants, a silverback, orangutan, you can't stop a train. Who wants some?